Welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. As you just saw, we're in Tarufa's Tower here with Badat and Hawk. Our party consists of Yurio and Chris, of course, as well as Stella and Joanna. And we're looking for Master Durzel, who's beyond this door, which is locked. But they have the key. And I don't need that. It was bad, I'd have to say. I'll watch out for people chasing you. Really? People? There's no people in here, just praying mantises or manti or whatever. Whoa, what'd you find? Stealth stuff I don't need, can't carry. Huck says, I'll open the door now. Well, I'm glad for that. Huck put the key into the keyhole of the door to the top floor and turned it. The door unlocked. Imagine that happening. That's what you happen when you use a key, huh? It's open now. Go. The soldier says, wait, intruders. Uh-oh, they're coming after us, says Badat. He kicked him back down the stairs. Woo-ha! I'll take care of them here. Go to Durzel quickly. He keeps knocking them down. That's funny. Leave the rest to us, says Huck. Well, Huck's just gonna stand there. Alright, let's go. Another door. Hopefully this one's not locked, because it could be a problem. Okay, good. Master Durzel, I presume? Ah, says Yurio. Ah, there's Durzel. He says, it's so noisy. What do you want from me? Joanna says, Grandfather! Joanna! I brought the people you've been waiting for so long. What? Such dramatic music. This is Yurio and Chris. They have been traveling as pilgrims, carrying the silver dagger. My name is Yurio. Nice to meet you. I'm Chris. We just completed our pilgrimage following the custom of Ragpig Village. I guess what's her name with the green hair? I guess she really doesn't matter. I keep forgetting her name. Stella? Her name's Stella. I'm pretty sure of it. Durzel says, I see. So the coming-of-age ceremony of Ragpig Village is obviously continuing. I heard several years ago that the custom was discontinued. Yurio says, that's because there weren't any children at the right age. The last pilgrim before us traveled around 5 years ago. It wasn't because the custom ended. Durzel says, so you carried the silver dagger and visited the 5 shrines according to the ancient tradition. Chris says, yes, we've been to all 5 shrines, Dean, Tagura, Agunis, Shifuul, and finally Aldos. Good. Yurio says, while we traveled, we heard stories in many different places telling of the Moonlight Witch. About Gweld, he says. Yes, we also saw in the magic mirror located in Aldos that Fulthia was going to lead the world to destruction. We know about the wave of Rayual, too. Durzel's speechless. Chris says, the great oracle told us that only those in another world know about the wave of Rayual. He also said that the Moonlight Witch was worried about it 20 years ago. That girl, Gweld, was, Durzel says. Yes, she was like a quiet evening calm, the exact opposite of the raging wave of destruction, Rayual. I think God still has some work for this old man. Durzel closes his eyes and remains silent for a while, as if contemplating something. Look, there's another room around the corner, too. Is this his bedroom? He's a pretty big jail cell. So you have the silver dagger with you? Yes, we do, says Yurio. Alright, then let's do it. What are we doing? Joanna says, Grandfather, here. Joanna handed Spear of Winds to Durzel. and he put the Spear of Winds on. You can't put it on, it's a spear. You can wield it. I know the translation isn't that great sometimes. Follow me. Let's get out of here. Chris says, but I'm lots of soldiers awaiting for us downstairs. I designed this tower myself. Luckily, Revas didn't know. I could have escaped any time I wanted to. So why didn't you? So he's going to show us a secret way. That's good, because I don't want to walk through all those stairs with all those praying mantises. Floors, not stairs. Durzel pushed a block of stones in the wall. Wow. Yurio says, wow, a secret escape. Ah, here's our friends. Badat says, it's not easy to kick someone without hurting him. Especially down a flight of stairs. Huck says, hello, Master Durzel. Nice to meet you. I'm Huck, Chris's uncle. Uncle, we don't have time for long introductions. Oops, says Badat. You go first. I'll keep the soldiers busy. Oh, they're coming, huh? I'll help too, says Joanna. Huck says, Yurio, Chris, you go with Durzel. Without you, nothing will happen. Right, says Durzel. Okay. Oh boy. Durzel joins the party. Wow. Actually, I didn't know that would happen. I don't know why it should surprise me at this point, though. Okay, so Durzel, first of all, has 327 hit points and 110 magic points. He's a sword master, so he's got to have a good sword, right? Oh, he has a Spear of Winds. That's right, Joanna gave it to him. He's got chainmail and a large shield. Nothing better than that. The Mirage Armor is better than his chainmail. We'll give him Mirage Armor. And the Spear of Winds, yeah, that's it. Well. And then we got some things that would help him. I'm gonna give him a guard ring plus 3. Gives him 20 more defense. We can give him 10 more defense if we wanted to. Or give him attack for 5 more defense. Or give him a speed ring. Give him 10 more speed. Oh, but look at that. Thomas's metal. Gives him 5 more attack and 5 defense. Yeah, that's gonna be it. Thomas's metal. Enjoy. Oh, what about magic? Yeah, that's surprising he doesn't have magic, so. He's got finishing moves, or a move, comet thrust, and skills. He's got whirlwind and piercing strike, devastating spear attack. That's the same as Joanna's. And whirlwind's an airy attack against nearby enemies. That's cool. Oh, an elixir, nice. Durzel says, thank you. That's all he has to say is thank you, thank you. Okay, never mind then. Anything else in here? No chests like in the ruins. Okay. I'm gonna save because we found an elixir just in case we die or something, we don't lose the elixir. Still wish we could hit arrow up to get to the end quickly. Okay. Got the express flight down here. Sweet. Will we go out through the water? Cool. Oh, we got a sluice through all the activity. You can't get us. Do we end up back in the town? Oh, there's a soldier there. Don't worry, says Yurio. The soldiers downstairs haven't noticed us. Durzel says, either way, it's just a matter of time before they come after us. I want to take you someplace. Come, quickly. Okay. Yurio says, ah! Why are we saying ah? Oh, our friends are coming. Bandit says, we can't keep fending them off without hurting them. We better run for now. I agree, says Durzel. Traveling together in such a big group will attract unnecessary attention, though. Let's split up and meet somewhere later. Joanna. Yes? You go with these two. Understood. Where are we going? Wait, are we switching members again? Durzel's face darkened slightly at Yurio's question. You'll know when you get there. Joanna, let's get going. Yes, Grandfather. Wait, so who's in our group? Okay, it's still them. Okay, never mind. I thought you meant Joanna come with us. So yeah, her name is Stella. We never introduced her. Poor girl. Oh, what'd you find in the water? No, we don't need that. Alright, so we need to go down this way. So that we can... Can we jump out of here? Okay. Now we can just head back to town. Yay! Where is everybody? Still hiding hide and seek? The soldiers in town don't know I escaped from the tower yet. Chris says, it's just a matter of time before they do. We should leave here as soon as possible. I agree, says Yurio. He's still playing hide and seek. Okay. Do we have anything else to do here in town? Try to talk to a few people. Senon says they say the queen is very beautiful. I wish I could see her just once. I don't remember that, but doesn't mean it didn't happen. And these people just sell things, right? Let's see if we can get something for him then. What are we using? Because we got a bunch of plus three rings. Power, resist, magic. Magic. Upgrade the power and the resist and magic, maybe. Let's do the exchange. Now we know what we're dealing with. Magic ring. Yes. Magic ring again. Yes. And then resist. Yes. This is going to upgrade from plus two to plus three. Seems like a good idea. Will we get power and resist? Okay. So Chris... could use this magic ring plus three. Going up another 10 in her resist. Or her attack, rather. Her magic attack. But she hardly ever uses her magic attack. Maybe it helps with her finishing move? Could be. Stella. Stella doesn't have magic. I'll give her a resist ring. Alright, so let's sell. Hemp cape. Veteran's cape. Let's sell this plus one stuff. She only have one. Sell the magic ring plus two. Both of them. Yeah, she's better off with, like, a resist or something. No, just leave it. Okay, so Yurio. Did we get resist? No, not yet. Starting to run out of money, though. Okay, so it makes his magic defense, right? 154. 164. Let's just sell all these plus two. Speed ring plus two. That's cheap. Keep those. So we want to upgrade his last ring, power ring. If she has it. Bring Yurio's attack up to 300. Wow. What am I doing? I'm in the wrong spot. So his attack now is 290, this will bring up to 300. Power ring plus 3. And we'll sell the plus two one. Okay, so what about... Yeah, I don't like how it brings his speed down. Who do you think the Spear of Winds is so important? They're selling it at the store, though. Robust shield for Durzel instead of the large shield. Yes, we'll buy that for him. We don't need to inspect our stuff, thank you. Okay, so his Defense going from 224 to 227. Only three, but... And we'll sell the large shield that he came with. I keep forgetting the food's there. Sell that. Alright, so we still have 6,000 left. Yay! Let's just save, because I don't want to do all that over again, just in case something happens. So I don't know what we do now. If we just leave... Let's check with everyone else, just in case... You just sell pet food, I'm not talking to you. There was somebody hanging out over here, wasn't there? Yeah, I remember him saying that. Yeah, they said all that stuff before. Feeling we're just supposed to leave the town. Yeah. Oh yeah, let's get some rest, actually. Good idea. Right back into this dramatic music. Yeah. We entered the tower, right? We fought the monsters, and we won. As a woman. Alright, let's leave. Out of my way! I'm gonna get out of this accursed place. Chris says, so where are we going? Arosa? Says Yurio. No, we've already been there. Durzel says no. Stella says, but you can't be thinking about... Durzel says, as a matter of fact, yes. Durzel nodded, affirming Stella's thought, although he was never introduced to her. We're going to see Gweld, he says. The Moonlight Witch, says Chris. Really? Says Yurio. Are you serious? Let's go. Okay, I guess she's up this way. So we're at Darufez. North is Arosa. 863 Milos, and then the Dilt checkpoint, 871 Milos. How did we end up all the way back here? Well, Arosa, yeah, this stuff should not be north, it should be west. Okay. I guess it turns west. I have no desire to fight these things. And they feel the same. Yeah, we're turning west. There's a lot of them, though. Oops, I almost ran into that thing anyway. don't need that. I'm trying to read the sign anyway. North is a Rosa, 85 Milos. Okay. Oh, that's right, they both lead that way. Back in a Rosa. Now what? This is where we found Joanna. These people have anything new to say to us? Sarent says, Master Durzel, many emotionless soldiers are gathering at the checkpoint lately. We're very, very nervous. Anon says, Anonymous, Master Durzel, you look very tired. Please rest as long as you want at our place. No, we don't need to rest. We just did. We haven't even fought anything since then. Pigel says, Oh, Master Durzel, welcome back. Our Rosa is safe now. Now that you're back, Master Durzel, I feel like working again. Were you being lazy before? Shame on you. So he thinks the Moonlight Witch is going to be here, or past here. Because up there is to Ragpick Village. I see you there, skulking about. Rico says, usually Joanna plays with me, but she ran by in a hurry today. She was with a scary-looking guy and a funny guy. Okay. Must be Badat and Hawk, respectively. Dick says, Oh, Master Durzel, your granddaughter and her friends headed north a little while ago. They were in a great hurry. Bene says, Master Durzel, you look well, Bene. Don't worry about me. I was worried about you. I'm glad to see you. Bene, I must settle a score from 20 years ago. Please take care of Arosa if something happens to me. Don't say stuff like that. I'll be waiting for your safe return, Master Durzel. Settle a score? He needs to settle a score with the Moonlight Witch? This is Joanna's place. Of course, nobody's home. So, they moved on to Ragpick Village, apparently. Or past it. Oh, that's you again. Sari says, Oh, Master Durzel, I'm so glad you're safe. Are you alright? Sorry to have made you worry, but 3 years of imprisonment doesn't hurt me at all. What'd she say? I'm so happy to see you unharmed. I feel relieved. So I know we're supposed to go north. Just curious what they would say if we head towards... All of a sudden, it's so quiet. If we head towards the Dilt checkpoint. There's no time to return to the checkpoint. We must hurry our way to Rudo. Okay. Question answered. Alright, let's all go north. Now that was in a dream that we ended up back in Ragpick Village. I wonder if we'd end up back there again. The Winter Solstice Pass. Sweet. Monstres. They were afraid of us. Alright, we'll fight you. But only you, understand? I remember these things. Yeah, they might all get one-shotted. Seafood and water marbles. The is the first time we get I think we have him already, actually. Yeah, that's our second batch of water marbles. We'll fight this thing. I'm eager to see what Durzel can do. That was him going? Yep. They're not gonna be able to hit this round. What a sad song. Sounds like a forlorn sounding song, doesn't it? Road of Remembrance. Interesting. What's going on here? Durzel says, good. I don't see anyone following us. Looking around for people following us? I haven't told anyone about this place except Joanna. I didn't want anyone from the castle to know about it. Come, follow me. Chris says, I wonder what's ahead of us. We should go, says Yo-Yo. You don't want to lose him. Maybe we did. Yeah, he left the party. How dare you leave the party? You just joined it. Oh, wow. That's certainly interesting. Oh, look, there's people. Oh, it's Huck, Bad-At, Joanna, and Durzel. Hey, Bad-At. Damn, he says. Since she's dead, that was her last prophecy. She's dead? That means her tracks end here. Was I supposed to talk to someone else first? Huck says, I can't describe how I feel right now. I was prepared for the possibility that we might have to face a sad truth like this. But I'm just really sad. Aww. It's like a cold wind blowing in the hollowness of my heart. I guess she's up there dead, which is not a good way to reveal that to us. Joanna? I'm glad to see you well. I was waiting for you. I've briefly explained what happened to Huck and his friends. All right, Ms. Durzel. This is the first time I've been here. You told me about this place before, but it's a very lonesome place. And she's talking to Durzel. This place is known as the Hill of Gweld. 20 years ago, after wandering through various countries, the Moonlight Witch Gweld finally fell into an eternal sleep here. Chris says, so the Moonlight Witch is dead. Is she really dead? Says Yo-Yo. Then we can't ask her about Rayuol. I can't believe it's been already 20 years. I remember it like yesterday. That's all that's left of her? Is a sword? Look, a sword, says Yurio. Why is a sword stuck here? Chris says, it must have been here for a very long time because it's rusted. That is my sword, says Durzel. I couldn't save that girl. That's why I left my sword with her that day. The sword that was the symbol of my position as court swordsman. I have no right to hold that sword again. Chris says, something is engraved on a stone monument. The inscription reads, Gagarv, 972. Here lies the goddess known as the Moonlight Witch. As you can see, says Durzel, Gweld is no longer with us. However, I think she can still help you, now that you are here. But she's dead, says Chris. True. However, her soul continues to live, even after her flesh has perished. That's the light of hope that Gweld left us. Yurio says, please tell us. How did the Moonlight Witch die? What is the light of hope Gweld is said to have left? Everything began on the beaches of Derufez. The beach of Derufez, says Chris? Yes. About 2 years before Gweld came to Tirasweel, a beautiful woman was washed ashore at Derufez. It could have been an accident or a well-crafted conspiracy. Nobody knew. King Rudolf, who was vacationing at the Tower of Derufez, found the woman. As the chief of the king's guardsmen, I warned him to be careful. After all, she had come from the witch's inland sea. However, King Rudolf was smitten by the beauty of the woman. My concerns came true. The two fell in love at once. Her name is Isabel. She is currently the Queen of Fothia. Queen Isabel, says Chris. She could have been a witch. I couldn't suppress my growing suspicions. No one knew about her past. Of course, I wasn't going to do anything unless something happened. I just couldn't stop feeling the bad vibes. 6 months passed after Queen Isabel had come to Castle Rudo. At the Queen's request, the King decided to build an observatory in the castle. The King insisted that astronomical observation was different from dubious fortune-telling, and granted her wish. The construction began immediately. I was suspicious, but it was not my place to object to a plan King Rudolf had already approved. Soon the observatory was completed, and an astrologer was invited as an authority of astronomy. That astrologer was Ravas. Ravas, says Yurio. He also showed up in Gondona and cast spells on Woolgit and Candata. Chris says, Bellart also mentioned Ravas. Durzel says, just like the Queen, he was also enigmatic. Everything was a trap. Now that I think about it, all the signs were there. I wish I had conveyed my uneasiness to King Rudolf. Anyway, I met Gweld around that time. I had heard of the Moonlight Witch, who was traveling through various countries and leaving prophecies with the local people. King Rudolf sent for me and gave me a secret mission. He thought the Moonlight Witch was distorting people's thoughts, so he ordered me to capture her. There were nasty rumors about her, many of which were biased views founded on the fear of witches. I personally thought there was no need to capture her. The King had never given me such an order before. King Rudolf was a wise man. Even if she was a witch, it was out of his character to order me to capture her without investigating the facts.